Hello everybody, my name's John. Today I'd like to share with you how I created my templates for my ARC notebooks. So ARC makes two different size notebooks. They make the larger version and then they make a smaller one. And of course, whatever size notebook you have, you're going to have to pick your pages to create your template. So for the larger notebook, you're going to have a page of 8.5 by 11. And then for the smaller version, you're going to have an 8.5 by 5.5. So I want to show you first off, here's a template very simply made for my large ARC notebook. It's 8.5 by 11. All I did was created a nice letterhead up here, and you could use this to write a letter. You could use this to put notes on if you're in college. You can use it for a million different things. Of course, you can change the font. You can change the color. Of course, you can tailor it to however you want. So there's one I made out of Microsoft Word, but of course you can also create it out of Pages if you have Pages for Apple. But let me show you what I made in Excel. Here's one that I made in Excel, and this is actually a weekly list that I actually use at work. So I have, you know, your different tasks that you have, you know, today's, next week's, the week, you know, however you want to set it up. So this is something that I actually use at work. Same way, change the color, font. You can change everything, tailor it to how you want. And if you have the ARC punch, of course, punch it, place it into your notebook. Now I want to show you another one that I made in Microsoft Word. And so maybe you haven't thought about doing this, but maybe say you're on a tight budget, and many of us are today, and you can't afford the leather-bound notebooks that ARC offers, or even the poly. They're even cheaper. There's ones that come in poly. Maybe those are still too pricey for you to afford. You can actually make your own. So, and you have to check out at Staples website, and I'm sorry that I haven't found out yet, but you can actually purchase, it's called ARC, the expansion disc. And I'm sorry that I don't have the price off right offhand, but something you can go onto the website and you can find out, or go to your nearest Staples store. And the one that I purchased is the 1-inch disc. I felt that one was going to be more suited for me. They have different sizes for you to pick from. But the one that I picked was 1-inch. It holds 150 sheets of paper. And it's 12 discs that it comes with. And so this is what I basically did, is I created my own notebook. So what I did was I made a template here. And I called it John's Notebook. Of course, you can change it to whatever color you want. 8.5 by 11 notebook page. And all I did is I went to Walmart, but of course you can shop anywhere, and I bought a thicker paper, like a cardboard paper or maybe a stock paper. And you can get that paper actually in many different colors. You can get it in, of course, white if you wanted to make your fonts to be a different color, like I did John's notebook here. Or you can make your page to be green, blue color, whatever the actual stock color comes in. And it's very simple. All you got to do is take that page, punch it into the note, into the ARC punch. Once you do that, you take your disc and then you slide them into your cover. And then you're going to get another cover for the back. And you're going to put that one on there. And then you just place your pages in there. So it's very, very simple if you wanted to create your own. And I'll be honest with you, I believe that these discs, I don't think I paid more than $3, $4 for them. And then you get your paper, however, you know, of course, based upon what kind of paper you buy, the color and everything is going to be determined how much that costs you. So, but you can really make a notebook, I would say, easily under $5 or $4. So, if you want to go that route. Now, let's go to the smaller notebook, because I think that's the one that many will say, well, how do you make a smaller notebook? Because it is 8.5 by 11 page, but how are you going to set that up to where it's going to look like 8.5 by 5.5? Now how I created mine is I actually created it in Microsoft Publisher. I found that it was the easiest way to create it in Microsoft Publisher. So here's my template, and this is for my small notebook. So I got my weekly list here, and I love this template. Because I can change the color, the style, the font. I can make up anything that I want to dream up. I can put it down on this. So it is just an awesome way for my ARC notebook. So let's get into real quick of how I created this. Let's open up a new page. So what you're going to do, if you have Microsoft Publisher, you're going to go to new, and let's pick out the blank five, the 11 and by 8.5, but we want it to be landscape. Okay, so this is a brand new page right here. So now how I got the guidelines to go down the middle is you just go up here to design, page design right here. You're gonna click on guides, and then they give you several different ones to pick from. And I just picked the first one here. And so what this did was you see that it now divided my page up. So our page is 8.5 by 11. The ARC notebook smaller version, we need it to be 8.5 by 5.5. So what I did is I took this here and I actually slid it. You can move it to wherever you want, so I put it right there. And then what I did is I actually just deleted the rest of these, and there you have it. So here is the green line here is my page divider. So it is 11 inches, and we got it now 5.5 inches. So whatever I put on this side is going to be one page. Whatever I put on this side will be the second page. So now it's simple. Whatever I want to do here, just go for it. So of course you can do, you can start writing anything you want, but maybe you want to do the grids like I did. You're just going to go to table, insert table, and then that's basically whatever you want to do. You can do how many rows you want. Let's say I would like to have 2 rows, number of columns, let's just do 6. And so now you have a grid like that. And of course, you can make it however you want. So if you want to do fonts up here, then all you got to do is go to insert. You got draw text box. So we're just going to draw a text box. Up here, you're just going to say and I just put something simple, John's notes. Of course, you can make that big however you want. Of course, we can center that. We can make it whatever font you want. We can change the color, whatever you want to do. So, John's notes. So, that's basically how I made my template up. It's actually really simple if you use Microsoft Publisher, because what it does, it allows you to divide the page. And then with this blue lines here, pretty much I would say keep it in between those lines. You're going to be better off. Take that back. You can write outside these lines, but what I wanted to say was keep it, you don't want to write in this space over here, because remember, when you punch it, if you put text out here, you're going to punch that the text, and so it's not going to look very well. So just make sure that you stay inside the blue line here. But now up here, of course, if you want, you can move it up here. That's not going to be any problem at all, because it is when you print this out, it's actually going to print. You can have all this space up here to write, but you just want to make sure when you punch, it's going to be punched right here, and it's going to be punched on this side as well. Because how I did it actually is I actually created it. Let me go back to my template to make it easier for you to understand. How I made mine was, you can actually do it two different ways. You see over here on the side, I have one page, and then I have a second page. So if you have a copier that you can print double-sided very easily, when I print mine out, I actually have it to print weekly list on one side, and then on the back side, it prints out the notes. So I have a weekly list on one side. When I turn the page, it actually has the notes on the second side. So you can do it that way and then just have to cut it down the middle. Then you can cut it down the middle and you have a weekly to-do list on one side, notes on the other. Now, if you don't want to do it that way, and you want your paper maybe to be a little thicker, all you have to do is print it out just one page only here, and then you just fold it in half. And you'll still have weekly to-do list on one side, and then on the back side, you can have your notes. Once you fold it in half, you can still punch it, put it into your notebook, and it works perfectly. But it makes it a little thicker if you want it to be a little thicker. Or, I guess, if you wanted to save paper, you could do what I did here. And all you do to create a double page is very simple. All you do is right-click on the page that you want, and you say Insert Duplicate Page. And when you do that, it puts a new page down here. So very, very simple to do. Now, I'm going to show you one more that I actually created. So this one here that I created, kind of a little bit different. I got a little more fancier with it. I made a calendar down here. I got June's calendar and July's calendar. I got it here. I put dates. So when I print this off, I can write the date of whatever this day is. I have a to-do list, 5 of them here. I can write them out, check them off here when I get things done. I do a lot of reading. So what I did was is I print out, you know, each one of these. I print out, like, say, a 5-day for a week. And I do a lot of reading Monday through Friday. So what I actually do is maybe on Monday I'm going to read a certain book, or maybe it's even a class that you take. So I check it off which one of those I'm going to read on a certain day. Have miscellaneous down here for 2. But of course this, you can set it up to however you want, whatever you want to call it, whatever you do. Maybe you're in school and you want to do a page for each class. And then here will tell you the up here, instead of saying John's Day with Jesus, you could have up here, you know, math class, English class, whatever you want. And then down here, you can put in to-dos, you know, homework, whatever it may be. Still got the calendar. And over here, you can have notes. So exactly the same way you can set this up as I did in my last one. You can do it double-sided, or you can just fold the page. So I hope this has maybe inspired you to create your own templates, and also to show you a little bit how you can do this. So I challenge you, if you have an ARC notebook, make some templates up. Now, of course, you can go to Staples and you can buy refill paper. And I'm not saying there is nothing wrong with that. Actually, it's a pretty decent price for the refill paper. It's thick paper, it's great quality, and instead of printing your own off, you can just buy it. It's already pre-cut. So then all you got to do is just put it into your notebook. You don't even have to have a punch to do that. But those of us who do have the ARC punch, and you want to get a little fancier, maybe add some color to it and make it more your style, I challenge you. Go out and make a template. And feel free to email me. Leave a comment down below. And maybe you even want to share with me, you know, your template that you made with either Pages or Excel, Word, Microsoft Publisher, whatever you created. I would love to be able to see what you created and what you designed with. So hopefully you enjoyed it, and I hope you are continuing enjoying your ARC notebook. So have a great day, everybody. Take care.